If you are diabetic, you know you should avoid candy. But what about fruit? Fruit does have natural sugars that can raise your blood sugar levels. However, the fiber, vitamins, and minerals in fruit makes it a healthy part of the diabetic diet. But the fact is, not all fruits are equal. So in this video, we'll explore the top 5 worst fruits for diabetics. Plus, you'll also discover something that we've been told is good for us, but actually wreaks havoc on our bodies. The golden rule to enjoy your favorite fruits without spiking your blood sugar. And for all those smoothie lovers out there, we've got you covered with some quick tips for diabetes-friendly smoothies. But first, take a moment to like this video and subscribe to our channel so you can get more diabetes-friendly tips to live a healthy and full life. And watch until the end to find out how you can get 2 free gifts on us. So, is there such a thing as a bad fruit? Before we begin, we should clarify. Fruits are good for you. Even ones high on the glycemic index and load chart are nothing compared to sweets or refined grains. All fruit contains fiber, which slows the absorption of sugars. Also, they contain plenty of vitamins and minerals. In fact, when it comes to the very worst foods for diabetics, fruits are not on the list. The worst foods tend to be sugary drinks, refined carbs, and sweets. But some fruits should be eaten sparingly, or you should watch your portion control with them. So with that in mind, let's jump into the top 5 worst fruits for diabetics. Number 5, bananas. Bananas can be good for diabetics, but there are specific bananas that should be avoided at all costs. A medium banana contains around 30 grams of carbohydrates. But fortunately, they're also a good source of fiber. Fiber helps to slow the absorption of blood sugar and reduce spikes. Moreover, bananas have one other golden nutrient, potassium. Potassium helps the body to produce insulin, a key for diabetics. But the thing with bananas is that they contain up to 15 grams of sugar, which can lead to problems. Why? Have you ever noticed how sweet a ripe banana tastes? That's right, it's all about how ripe your banana is. As a banana ripens, resistant starches turn into sugar. Resistant starches help the body to slow digestion. So the greener the banana, the more resistant starches you get, helping to maintain healthy blood glucose levels. On the other hand, if a banana is overly ripe, it will have a lot more natural sugar. In fact, a study published in the Journal of Diabetic Medicine observed exactly how much bananas transform as they ripen. Underripe bananas scored 43 on the glycemic index, making them a medium GI food. But overripe bananas scored a staggering 74, making them a high GI food, and a food that diabetics should avoid. So if you love bananas, buy them green and eat them as early as your taste buds permit. And here's a pro tip. Pair bananas with foods containing protein or healthy fat. Protein and healthy fat work to slow down blood sugar absorption, reducing blood sugar spikes. So pair your banana with peanut butter, nuts, Greek yogurt, or your favorite protein. Number 4. Pineapple. The pineapple is a sweet fruit. Per cup, a pineapple has around 22 carbs and 16 grams of sugar, with a little over 2 grams of fiber. It's far better than a bowl of candy, but still requires caution for diabetics. However, pineapple is packed with beneficial nutrients too. It has more than your daily recommended amount of vitamin C. It also has over 75% manganese, which may help regulate blood sugar. Plus, it contains other important vitamins and minerals. It's packed with antioxidants that can fight disease and has enzymes that can aid in digestion. So like the banana, it may not be bad for you in moderation. However, it's best to check your blood sugar and understand how your body responds. And if you're going to indulge, it's a good idea to pair your pineapple with healthy fats and protein. Good options include lean meat, cheese, nuts or seeds, or enjoy your pineapple in a diabetic-friendly stir-fry. Finally, if you do eat pineapple, make sure that it's not canned. Canned pineapple is absolutely loaded with added sugars and syrups. Cut out the added sugar and go au naturel. Now, before we get to number three, it's time to reveal your two free gifts. Get an in-depth look at the foods which help you fight diabetes. Grab our free book, The 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar, and learn what's really happening inside your body. And watch our free one-hour documentary, The Scary Truth About Sugar. Simply click the link in the description below to gain full access to both gifts. All right, let's return to the list. Number three, mangoes. Mangoes are another fruit to exercise caution with. Mangoes have around 25 grams of carbohydrates per cup and a whopping 22.5 grams of sugar. A mango does have 2.6 grams of fiber, but is that enough? Well, let's look at its other nutrients. It's a good source of vitamin C and copper. In right levels, copper helps your body turn food into fuel. Also, it is a good source of folate, vitamin A, E, and it has some potassium. Mangoes also have antioxidants, which can help to reduce the impact on blood sugar. So far, we can see that mangoes do have some great benefits, but it's worth noting that different people react differently to foods, and mangoes tend to be one food that can cause problems for some diabetics. So while person A may have a strong reaction, person B may have much less of a response, depending on factors such as lifestyle, diet, exercise, and genetic makeup. The key with foods like mango is portion control. The Journal of Social Health and Diabetes recommends no more than 150 grams per day. And remember to follow the golden rule. Accompany your mango with another high protein or high fiber food. Good pairings include beans, cheese, or salad. Now, our next fruit is a popular treat and is one of the most antioxidant-rich foods available, but it can cause chaos for diabetics. Can you guess what it is? We'll reveal that in just a moment, but first, let's talk about fruit juice. Once considered a healthy option, we now know that fruit juice is a recipe for diabetes disaster. Most fruits can be good for you in moderation. Even the worst fruits contain fiber, helping to mitigate their blood sugar impacts. However, with fruit juice, all the healthy fiber has been stripped away, causing blood sugar levels to quickly spike. According to World Health Organization guidelines, just half a pint of fruit juice exceeds the recommended daily intake of sugar. In fact, drinking one glass of orange juice equals 2 to 4 oranges minus the fiber. So while fruit juice may be better than soda, caution is advised. If you really want juice as a special treat, choose a quality natural juice and mix it with sparkling mineral water. But eating the entire fruit is always going to be better. Fruit smoothies are in a similar ballpark. Like juice, smoothies have very little fiber. Now, if you can't imagine life without the beloved smoothie, I have good news for you. Smoothies can stay on the menu. In fact, they can be a great option. The trick is to get your combinations right. Here are some tips to make your smoothie more diabetic friendly. First of all, vegetables are a must. A handful of spinach or kale will reduce your smoothie's glycemic load and give you a healthy shot of vitamins, iron, potassium, and calcium. Also, add some healthy fats to it. Avocado is a great option, and it adds an amazing silky texture. Add a few nuts and seeds. These are going to boost protein, fiber, and fat, helping to stabilize blood glucose. Either blend them into the smoothie or sprinkle them on top. And most importantly, avoid smoothies made purely of fruit. Also, be cautious with smoothies from restaurants, as these are often extremely sweet and may even be sweetened with added sugar. So get creative with your smoothies. There's a world of delicious yet health-boosting combinations to explore. Okay, back to our list. Number 2, dates. Do you feel like going on a date with dates? This dried fruit is so sweet, it almost feels criminal. Unfortunately, this makes it a bit controversial with diabetics. A 7-gram date has about 20 calories, its carb count is 5.3, and it has 4 grams of sugar. It has 0.6 grams of fiber, too. The problem is that being small, you may be tempted to eat a handful, which quickly adds up. But don't give up on dates just yet. On the flip side, they are nutrient-rich and offer a number of health benefits when consumed in moderation. According to a review of 10 studies comprising of 390 people, those who consumed dates had reduced fasting glucose levels and blood glucose levels after eating. The researchers believe that high levels of fiber and minerals, particularly magnesium, may be responsible for this. While this area of research is still young, it suggests that eating dates in moderation may in fact be beneficial for diabetics. Furthermore, dates are a good source of polyphenolic compounds, which play a role in maintaining brain health. Laboratory research on mice indicate potential benefits of dates for memory, cognition, and preventing age-related decline. One study published in the Journal of Neural Regeneration Research suggests that dates provide possible protection against oxidative stress in the brain, and that these fruits show potential in the fight against Alzheimer's disease. So go ahead and enjoy these sweet treats in moderation. Just limit your portion to 1 or 2. Pair them with nuts or cheese, or chop them up and add them to a salad. Now to our last worst fruit. Number 1, raisins. Raisins pack a huge sugar punch, and they have too much sugar for diabetics. A quarter of a cup of raisins has 29 grams of carbohydrates and 21 grams of sugar. That's a lot of sugar for such a small portion. It does have 1 gram of fiber and protein, and it's a good source of several vitamins and minerals. It's also a good source of boron, which can be good for your bones and cognition. But the sugar content is very high for diabetics. Your best bet? Go with another fruit instead of this one. But if you must, limit your portion and make them an occasional food. And as always, pair them with foods containing protein, healthy fats, and fiber. So, is fruit bad for you? Not at all. The best way to think about it is that some fruits are better than others. Some of the best fruits include blackberries, which are high in fiber. Also, avocados, they're filled with healthy fats. However, the fruits that have higher sugar can still be enjoyed in moderation. Remember to eat them with a good protein or fiber source. Every diabetic is different, especially with reactions to fruit. Some can eat a banana with a very little increase in blood sugar. However, others may see a big spike. Ideally, check your blood sugar after eating a sugary fruit. If it goes up, try pairing it with a protein or fiber. If it still rises, lower your portions. If you're still having issues, you may need to cut it out of your diet or seek further advice. But the simple fact is, most fruits can be enjoyed as part of a balanced diet. We hope this has helped to grow your understanding of diabetes and how you can take control of your health naturally. Now, a question for you. What is your favorite combination of fruit and protein? Let us know in the comments. For me, it's gotta be sliced kiwi fruit with a little cottage cheese on top. Delicious. And if you have any questions, leave it in the comments. We love hearing from you, and your comments help us to produce more great content that will serve you best. Before you leave, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel. We're regularly releasing new videos to answer all of your diabetes-related questions. And don't forget about those two free gifts. Just click the link below to gain access to both. Thanks for watching and have a diabetes-fighting day.